to talk to you about one particular aspect of our business that concerns you all directly. Accidents. The cost of any accident, based in terms of both human emotion and finance, can be enormous to those directly involved. The emergency services, the community, and of course, to each of us. In terms of pure finance, the most costly to us are those resulting in injury to a third party. This can be the result of a moment's inattention, or perhaps even carelessness by one of our drivers. And such a claim can arise from an accident which appears minor in nature, with little or no visible damage, where the impact between the vehicles may have occurred at less than walking speed. Here in this office, the paperwork for every accident involving the personnel and vehicles is processed. Every year, some 3,500 accident files pass through our hands. Unfortunately, a significant number represent situations in which our drivers are blameworthy to varying degrees. It is essential that our drivers have sufficient rest before they begin their shifts. In the incident you're about to see, the driver could be anyone, even you.
Driver is tired and it will cause him to make a mistake. He will overtake another vehicle and force it onto the motorway hard shoulder. This sort of thing is far more common than you might think these days. A report from the Transport and Road Research Laboratory has concluded that fatigue is a factor in 11% of all road accidents which occur nationally. It is also a fact that all drivers will face fatigue after 4 hours driving. The estate car driver wasn't hurt in this case, but decided to report our driver to the police. The consequences that follow will no doubt be very serious for him, all because of a simple, but potentially lethal mistake by a tired driver. Drinking even a moderate amount the evening before an early shift can in some cases cause a driver's blood alcohol level to exceed the legal limit. There have been over 105,000 convictions in respect of motorists' alcohol or drug consumption. In a 12-month period during 1995 and 1996, over 2,000 accidents were reported to our motor insurance office. In financial terms alone, the costs amounted to over £2.5 million. During the first 3 months of 1996, over 750 accidents of all types were reported to us, and in all, 818 claims forms issued to third-party representation. Of that total, we know that 456 of our drivers were at fault. Most of the accidents we see occur during very basic vehicle manoeuvres. Reversing, for instance. Over one third of all those accidents reported to us involved our vehicles reversing in some way. Even what looks like minor damage can give rise to enormous claims being made against us. 214 of our drivers collided with the vehicle in front of them. 131 caused accidents while turning left, while another 81 caused them turning right. Do you recognise yourself? Over 1,500 of our drivers will. A lot of accidents are caused by carelessness. Every accident is avoidable. Before any manoeuvre, always check your rearview mirrors. And when you're sure it's safe, check again. When reversing, always double check the area you are about to reverse into. It is always best to get out of your cab to physically check if you can't see properly using your mirrors, or you just aren't completely sure. This young woman walking along with a child in a pushchair is partly masked from our oncoming driver's view by a wall. He intends to turn left, and as room is limited, cuts the corner. Fortunately, she reacts quickly enough to prevent an accident. Cyclists can present problems for any driver, and this one is no exception. He squeezes through the narrow gap between the rear of our vehicle and the near side kerb, passing under the vehicle mirrors. Our driver moves off, and the accident happens. The cause? Inattention and a simple mistake. Having an accident is so very easy. Anyone can do it. It's just that sometimes they cost too much. For example, when approaching a roundabout, never assume what the driver in the vehicle in front of you will do. The roundabout may be clear, but that doesn't mean that they will keep going or move off straight away. Assuming what a driver will do and acting on that assumption can be fatal. Always check, and then check again. Even when manoeuvring room is limited, don't take chances. It could be someone far more vulnerable who gets hurt. The TNT Driving Handbook, in the Expressing Excellence series, lists the driver's responsibilities and daily checks. We would stress again the importance of checking that your vehicle's rearview mirrors are clean and adjusted to suit you, and that the lights, particularly the tail lights, are also clean and working correctly. Please exercise that bit of extra care. Don't be another statistic. Every accident is avoidable.
The motorway network in Lancashire extends for almost 200 carriageway miles, and with the completion of the M65 by the summer of 1997, that mileage will increase by a further 30%. Anyone working in this environment regularly, in the capacity of a police officer, will eventually see almost every situation imaginable. There can be no doubt that motorway driving presents an experience quite unique to the general public, and although the problems in which we find some drivers involved are common to any area, you might consider the motorway presents an environment which is in itself so different to driving in, say, a suburban setting, and can instill a false sense of security both in the inexperienced and the seasoned professional who spends a lot of his working day there, either commuting or travelling from one part of the country to another. Overall vehicle design has improved so much now that even in the largest commercial vehicle, the driver is fairly well insulated from what, in reality, can be an extremely hostile environment. To survive without incident of any kind today, with the vastly increased numbers of vehicles using the road networks, a driver has to be in pretty good shape, both physically and mentally. Drivers must be able to react quickly. They must be able to see a situation that is developing into a potential problem for them, and then be physically able to respond as necessary. I'm sure that no one in their right mind would wish to be involved in any accident at all, but the likelihood increases if the driver is tired. This need not be after spending hours driving. It can be before the journey has begun. If any driver, particularly a professional, who earns a living driving daily, reports for work tired, then he or she, as the case may be, will not really be able to concentrate or react as they may well have to in a situation which could arise through no fault of their own. They can be well within their legal obligations as far as driver's hours are concerned, but really they have put themselves into a position which, if things go wrong, could affect them for the rest of their lives. Concerning the motoring public, it could be said that we see them at their best and, unfortunately, at their worst. Tailgating or driving too close is all too common now. Should the driver in front have a problem and his vehicle reduce speed unexpectedly, then it's physically impossible for the driver behind to react quickly enough to prevent a collision. Experienced professional drivers put themselves at risk every day. Speed, of course, is one of the main factors when things start to go wrong. People are people, and they become used to travelling regularly at speeds that would have been impossible to maintain only a few years ago. And although in today's workplace, most drivers are required to travel quickly over considerable distances, there is one constant fact, and that is, speed kills.
Now will be a good time to look at some of the facts of speed and relative braking distances. At 60 miles an hour, it would take the driver between 7 and 9 seconds to bring this vehicle to a stop with the brakes fully applied. This means that the vehicle would travel 18 metres, or 59 feet, before the driver could even press the brake pedal, and would cover 73 metres, or 240 feet in all, before coming to a stop. Remember, these are minimum stopping distances. In adverse conditions, they can be doubled, trebled, or even quadrupled. From 50 miles an hour, it takes 53 metres, or 175 feet to stop with the brakes fully on. That's 13 car lengths. At 30 miles an hour, the distance comes down to 6 car lengths. That's 23 metres, or 75 feet. Road rage isn't new. It's just becoming more common as the level of violence in our society increases. Here, an incident is triggered by a driver pulling out of a depot and causing the car driver some inconvenience. These days, the dangers of confrontation cannot be overstated.
What do you think you're playing at, you? 38, Johnson, is it too loud? Open the door, stop it here. Open this door! Open it! I'll open the door, please, you know! I said, open the door! Open the door! No, we're calling the police!
Our driver is using his cab phone to summon help, and this brings the incident to a close. In a recent incident, a youth climbed onto the front of one of our vehicles whilst it was moving at low speed through a town centre, in similar circumstances to these here. If anything like this should happen to you, always stop your vehicle.
What do you think you're playing at? Open our window.
Close the cab windows and secure the doors. Draw attention to the situation by switching on all the vehicle lights and sounding the horn. In extreme circumstances, use your cab phone to summon help. Do not retaliate.
Get off! He's phoning the police!
Do what? Do what?
You may decide to contact the emergency services directly, rather than go through the TNT security system. Dial 999, or the new international emergency number, 112.
Yes, operator. Can I have a place in Lancashire? Thank you.
It is most important to help the operator by including the county area you were in at that time. This will prevent confusion and the need to have your call redirected later. Cameras and film are given to all our drivers now for them to take photographs of any accident they may be involved in. Use them. It has been proved they can work in the driver's favour. Take as many photographs as you can, as well as writing down anything you consider to be important. This is a recent claim submitted on behalf of a third party against one of our drivers, alleging carelessness on his part. However, the photographs he took at the accident scene told a different story and enabled us to dismiss the claim.
Make sure you are one of our drivers that go home safely at the end of the working day. Remember, think safety and drive safely.
Good afternoon, Peter Hay, Insurance Department. How may I help you?
Oh, hello. My name's Yvonne Weall. One of your drivers in a lorry has just hit me in the back of my car.
Right.
The back of my car's bashed up and I want to know what you're going to do about it.
Okay. Is your vehicle not drivable?
No.
Perhaps not. So it is very badly damaged, yeah. The thing we need to do immediately is to talk to the